Myself Sugandha Singh. So today I am your host. We all know why we all are gathered here. So we have a group discussion on the topic that I'll tell you, which is a very prominent matter of concern for we youth. So today your topic of discussion will be, is India ready to go cashless? So you all have to put your views on this. Either you all are in favor or in against of this. So without wasting too much of your time, start putting your points forward. All the best from my side.
Hello all of you. My name is Sachin. And today we are here to discuss on topic, as Sugandha told, is India ready to go cashless or not? So this cashless society started when the government decided to ban 85% of currency in November 2016, which forced many people to move towards cashless society.
Hello everyone, I am Ritik and I am agree with Sachin. The cashless of making India is started when they demonetized the notes of 500 rupees and 1000 rupees. As we all know, cashless economy refers to the flow of currency through electronic channels such as debit card, credit card, internet banking, and etc. etc. The cashless economic activity usually happen in three different modes, as you know, namely mobile or e-wallet and plastic money or internet banking. Thank you.
Hello everyone, myself Pramjit, and I also think that moving towards the cashless society is a better opinion than having cash. So I will put in my views on it.
Hello everyone, I am Nakul. So I will say that moving toward cashless is not totally good, because the apps we are using like Paytm are the 60% of the shares with China. So we are not totally sure about our data, that it is going to be saved or it is going to be used for other purposes, or many scams are there in India or in the world that we can't find our data and our full money in our accounts will be finished just in seconds. So it's not totally good to move cashless.
Hello everyone, myself Nishant, and I agreed with my friend. I also add one more point. Like India is a developing country, there is a lack of internet access. Not everyone has a 4G smartphone supporting Reliance Jio. The transaction on high internet, once the offer period is over, those who have served to all to have bear the high internet charges to use high speed internet, it is very difficult for the workers, vendors not able to afford data pack to support cashless transactions.
But Nishant, the cashless transaction provide us the proper detail of every transaction that we do. Each and the smaller one transaction also we can track them, and with the help of record we can manage our finance and investments properly. So, and we have a more modes of transaction in cashless, like phone pay, Google Pay and UPI apps, etc., e-wallets, plastic money, then net banking and NEFS and IMPS like that. So we have very variety of modes in this cashless transaction.
I'm agree with the Sachin, but there are some problems which stand in the way of India becoming a cashless society, and the main is due to even use of digital payments leads to the convenience, but there are more prone to the risk of threats and hacking. People are hesitated to use digital payments modes as there will be a risk of revealing of our identity and personal details and so on.
I agree with your point, Ritik, but the other thing is our India's cyber law and IT cells are working on it. As my friend said, there are many apps which are from China. Firstly, I would like to correct him. It was 40% of Chinese share and 60% of India's share. So it's no worry about using Paytm. The servers are also located in India. And I will also like to add that, as we all know, recently government of India has banned some apps such as TikTok, PUBG and others, which were that in coming period of time. So our cyber cell and cyber laws experienced teams are there to protect our data.
Okay, my friend Pramjit, but I would like to add one more point, that India 77.7% of people are only taught people. Other peoples are untaught, and in villages there is very network issues and people are untaught. So how they can use smartphones and how they can do transactions all over the world.
As Nakul, you are saying that the 4G connectivity problem, the government has introduced one mode that is known as USSD mode. So by with the help of USSD, you can make transactions even offline, like the area where 4G is not available. So you can make transactions with USSG. It's like just dialing a code *99 has in your mobile, entering details, and your payment is done. And phone transaction companies like Google Pay and PhonePe are working on this method, like how to make a transaction possible at 2G connection also.
One more problem, that is affordability of smartphone. In India, many people are below poverty lines and are not having enough money to afford the smartphones, even when new and inexpensive phones are launched by the companies. And there are some more problems like lack of technical knowledge. While the new generation is closely linked to their phones and gadgets, but the computer literacy among the people in over 50 group age is still low. There are many people who are not comfortable with the use of mobile phones or computers. They still are dependent on their children for using these gadgets.
I agree with you, Ritik, but I will contradict your statement by saying that our first priority is our nation, and by having cashless mode, our security forces and the people serving the nation can have a financial reward on the people who are accused or are victims and to be accused. Means we have everything on them, eyes and ears, through the electronic media, and many threats such as terrorism and bomb blast, etc., can be prevented by taking a little effort on this.
Yeah, Paramjit, I agree with your point, but in India, there are some areas like in Jammu Kashmir where the government has to ban the internet for some time, and it is very bad for everyone to use cashless at that time. So how we can proceed the cashless at that time?
As you are saying that the internet is banned at that moment, but it's not every time this happens. It happens in some situations like this Jammu and Kashmir, it is a political reason, but we can use some other, at that moment we can't use cashless, but we can use other payments, but in some certain problems are there. But normally if we see, we have a good servers and all that stuff to use cashless, and we don't have to carry our wallet each and every time to pay some our bills. We can simply just carry our phone and make our payments.
I would like to add some points in my friend Sachin's statement that these are circumstantial situation and this never occur
exactly
every time. So we can, for a progressive country like India, a cashless economy is the only way to make our GDP and other factors to grow. Also, the revocation of Article 370 in Jammu Kashmir, this was another and circumstantial but political reason also, which led to the country move towards there.
I am agree with both of you guys, but there is the internet cost in India is still substantially high. There is no Wi-Fi at public places, and if people do not get their monthly data packs recharged, there is no way that they can connect it to make an online payments. Internet connectivity is needed even for the e-wallets and something else.
But Ritik, as the research and has seen that the internet usage has grown after the demonetization. In 2016, when demonetization came in place, the internet users were 450 million. But now with the end of 2020, it was expected to touch 700 million. So internet users are growing day by day.
I agree, but India is a developing country. There is a shadow of literacy. There are people who don't have know about credit card, debit card. They work for whole day for their wages in their hands, and they have satisfied their daily needs. Our people cannot adapt the change immediately. So the government should provide training to illiterate people how to transition.
My friend Ritik said that data packs are very costly, but Stin already explained that without data packs, by USSD method, we can do transaction cashless. Another thing
is, government is also working on it to improve this illiteracy problem by teaching people properly, like giving advertisements like do not share your confidential information, and improving awareness in people's like advertisements in TVs, and while we call, we receive a small advertisement and all that stuff. It's working towards it.
I also want to put some data in it. By the first quarter of this year, our data users were 475 million, which eventually grown by 475% and proceed regulars record that India has achieved in the second quarter by the end of 2020.
Yeah, Paramjit, but the employment in the banks will be taken off. The people, those who are working, there will be less people working if the India will go cashless.
It can be solved as if we more switch our mode to cashless, the employment grows in the field of IT and cyber threats and hacking, the employment will raise eventually. The cashless method is also the plastic money method, such as debit card and credit card, which will not affect the employment of banks.
Exactly, or the bank members are also, we are not just completely wiping off the cash. We are progressing towards it, like taking a step forward day by day or year by year. So we can't do it in one day that from now no cash. It's working towards it.
Chin, I agree with you, but there is one more problem that most people still do not have bank accounts, and most often there is just one account per family, which also limits the number of cards people can have individually. A family of even four people cannot be dependent on only just one card for all the household expenditure.
I will add one point here, that the people, those are working for 500 rupees per day, they can't put their 500 in banks, and the bank will put the limit for keeping some money. So what they will do for cashless then?
Government of India already initiated making of banking accounts through the many schemes we have seen in previous some months and years. The government is initiating on it, and we can predict the situation that for 20% of people, we cannot let our country to go in threat of cyber security. Means the security forces can have it tracked very frequently and in a good sense that we can, our forces can
increase, let people
victims
come will open their accounts, which is helping them to grow day by day. And government is also trying, like they can link their Aadhaar with this bank account so that they get a seamless connection between both of them, so people come forward and make their account. So government is also trying to, the like in villages they have this post banks, post office banks, and it's working on it. Government is working on it.
It is our duty also, as India is our country, so we should step, the youth should step ahead for this cashless economy.
From all of our the discussion, I want to conclude that Government of India plans to digitize every corner of the nation, but it is still in a long run unless every citizen is made aware about digital economy. It makes our life easy, simple, and so we have to proper support cashless economy. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. So we ran out of time also. So from your discussion, many points were really strong in against also, in favor also. Well done, guys. So from your whole discussion, I came to know that, yes, India is definitely a progressing country. It is progressing towards going cashless, but it has to wait for something. Cashless society is a distant dream, but a less cash society is still a possibility. So thank you so much, guys. We will stop here. Thank you so much.